Alright, welcome back to Blickling. Here we are again, carrying on with field 6, Par Harren 6, ready to put in, forget which way around I was going to put them now, I'm afraid put them in the opposite way around, so but one is going to take spuds and one is going to take beak, and he's going well, but we're also, don't know why, we're also going to be moving that left bunker to Blickling. I found a sell point. I'll set up courses. I'm just going to hope they work. The last tractor I've got is just one. It looks like he's lost his weights off the front. So we just bungle back on. About 800 kilos, I think, just so he doesn't wander about too much. I'm driving fairly fast on the course, and if you're driving fast, you need to have a bit of weight on the front, if not, it just skids out. We hope we got it right. It's a little bit left in the other bunker, which, when he's done this, we'll go into the mix feeder, I think. I can't remember how far we got. Let's find out. I know we're still waiting for straw and up coming to the next harvest. Now we've got some silage in there. We'll just top that right up. We've got some hay in there. And we just need straw. And we'll start on that. But what I'm going to do is just have a walk around the fields. Well, actually, if we take this out and have a quick check around the fields. Let's see what we got, and I've been a bit ruthless with my mod folder on this. I have kicked out a whole load of mods which either going to be too small for this farm, or they're throwing out a load of errors. Some are throwing out warnings still, and I think one is still throwing an error, but I'm going to keep that and just keep my fingers crossed. I also added a few mods. Go figure, you want to clear the mod folder out, so you add some. Well, this was, I had to clear some out because this mod folder was getting ridiculous. It's getting close to 300 mods in there, which is asking for trouble. Alright, let's see what we've got in here, what this is like. We want some rain. We only want to spray some water on here. I think we might go and rent. Yes, we do. A little bit of acidity in there, but that's not a problem. Let's just see if we've got any rain on the horizon. 2 days' time. We're on this. I think we're still going to go and get some water. I think we're going to spray some water about. And the big problem is finding where I can fill water. It's not the easiest thing in the world to get. I found to get to them on this map. So I'm going to put this up. We'll go down to the shop. We'll rent a sprayer and we'll spray some water about. I'm probably saying that as soon as I do that, it will start to rain, but let's not worry about that. And we're going to have a bit of money now, because we've got a little bit of money there, because this course I've got to Blickling, I have took, I think, two bucketfuls down there on the trailer to check the course actually works, and to check what I thought the tip point was. The tip point. I'll begin to learn, you see, I'm testing things before I'm actually showing them. This will not last. Believe me, it will not last. I'm still enjoying this map, and actually after the weekend of playing with stuff on the heritage map to try and get it to work, this is going to be a relief with everything working. Right, we just park up here. I will do the park. Oh, not too bad. I'm almost in there. A bit over a bit one side, a bit there. Right, man, just... Oh, we might as well do this. The proper way we actually go to the shop. Right, what I want to do is rent a sprayer. I know I've got me little sprayers like that, but I've got no tractors to use them. Oh, this is about the best bit. So the knights, we'll rent that. I'd like to use this stuff. Which is that and that. And that goes with, just to show you some of the stuff I've been adding. I don't know if I show you, I'd added the two bigger combines. I like class combines. Right, no bones about it. But we also added these two JCBs. I'm not certain how they go, how good they are, anything, but we'll probably give them a try at some point. In fact, what would it cost if we were to rent, say, that? And that's cheaper to rent the other way. Now, what else do we do? And main reason I got that class pack is these two trailers, header trailers, they actually work. They actually lock nicely. I've been using those on Smokedown. I also brought this in and got rid of the little ag gap, or what the avcram trailers, and I've got this instead. This is for seed. We've got an extra plow. This is a new one from SLB. It's standard one. I think that's DJ's, just calm the bounce down on it a bit. No real change there. I just chucked out a whole load of really small sewing machines because not really going to use it. This is still throwing out a few errors, but I'm going to stick with it. See what else we've done. Oh, we chucked out a few of the tanks here. And we have got this pack. We've got the latest Universal Pack, Cock Universal Pack. Basically, I've got this little small one. This will be nice for some of the stuff we need. We're not going to need the really big stuff, and this should work a bit better. Also, it's got this little tank here for carting stuff about on. No difference there. Oh, we've got this windrower. This is that belt windrower on Mod Hub. I'll give that a try. No difference. I chucked out nearly all the Marshall bale trailers because, again, I'm not as keen on them as I am these for legals. So we're going to stick with legals. Not that I'm going to do much baling on here, to be honest. This is a round bale unroller. It makes compost, it makes mixed feed and sort and all that stuff. Weight's no different. Just chuck that electric car out because I'm not going to use it on here. This is one I really want to use, but I'd already got the JCB in. But I will use it on one map soon. This I want to buy. And I chucked out a few things out of here. Let's go back and get this sprayer. I think we'll take the knight. I think this is the Mark II, I'm not certain. But we'll rent that for 3 hours. Oh, 4 hours, go on. Dead devil weather. And a full day. Let's go find it. There it is over here. This I know is a very nice machine. I use this on a lot of maps. It can be a bit of a pain to turn on the road because it's four-wheel drive with the booms extended, four-wheel steer with the booms extended, but two-wheel steer, just front-wheel steer with them tucked in for road use. And I should really put those on. We ought to hop in the cab. Now we've got to find the where the waters are. I think I better just look at the map just to remind myself where it is. Oh, there's one lot of water down near the mill. I wonder actually if we'd be better off. We're closer to go down near the mill, I think, so we'd better turn around and go back to the mill. Then we can come in and take the fields in as we find them. He says, hopefully. We'll need to come out of cab to do this. But this is a very nice one. This is just a remodel by Pretorius of the Amazon, which you may well remember from 13, which I think was given away for early orders on 7/4/15. But this is a reskin of that, and it's a very nice job indeed. Someone said in here, Travis Perkins, that this has got the pallet stuff on here. Let's have a look. I don't know if that's this one or another merchant. Let's have a look. Can't see the stuff in here. It could well have. It's got stuff all over the place here. I shall. Not that I'm going to be doing any upset. Can't leap as my age. Not I'm going to be doing any logging. It's not my cup of tea. I will be getting some animals. I think once we're sold at silage, we should better start. Animals. I think it's down here. I hope we've gone the right way. Oh yes, I can see the water sign to one side. Now all we've got to do is find a way through to it. Ah, there's a track off here now. Does this take us there or not? Or is this a case of... Ah, we have to back in and fill up now. I don't know if we can. We will find out. No, we don't really want to damage this, but... Well, let's walk around for a minute before we go mad. Ah, wait a minute, this tar. This tar looks familiar. This must be the water tar. This is a case of where you fill up from. Rather than diving there and upset his fishing. I think I'm going to want to put this up so I can see where the fill point is. In here. This is the problem with this, it hasn't got a very good turning circle. I wonder if we're meant to back onto this. I'm guessing this is what it is. I've done all that other stuff to it. Fill up. I haven't played with this. No, it isn't going to fill from here. Perhaps we can't fill it straight with water. I know if you fill those universals up, I think you can put them on, so we go back to the farm. We say goodbye to Alsham Grain. Or whatever name this goes under. Oh, we had a nice little run around. We just had to fill up from the I'll fertilise a bay, hopefully we can get in there. I was hoping I could have filled it straight with water, but that ain't to be. Anywhere else being filled with water. Not certain if there's any fertilizers cell points around here. Oh, get away from the edge. This is a nice little mod, but I do like this. Oh, it looks like he's gone and sold one load. And it looks like he's come back again. I promise you can't actually see it here. Oh yeah, it's just turned into a yard now. So it looks like that course is working. Do one first and see what the others are like. If we fill this right up, there should be enough to do all our things. We'll go in. All right, that refill. I think there's about a 41 metre spread on this thing. It's a stupid size. Which means I will be catching on everything. Just having a drink, by the way. And that holds a lot. This holds more than the Amazon. The Amazon holds about 4 and this holds about 5,000. Yes, dead on 5, right now. Water, that's the one we want. That looks like they're filling again. Let's get rid of this again. So everything is it's full bore, all 3 tractors. Working. They won't be working when I come to see. Oh, but they could. I'm actually going to have to rent a potato seeder. I'm going to have to hold some spuds back for next year as a seed now. It's come out so we can actually see what we're doing. Unfold. I just want to move that forward a bit more. I look right out for this. As I keep getting told, I would need big equipment on this farm, so here we go with some big equipment. Now, I can't remember how we dropped that on the mouse. There we go. Just drop the boom down a bit. Don't want to take it right down, but now we should have 4 wheels. Steer now, turn on sprat. There we go. Oops, and put up enter forward. And away we go. I don't know how well we're going to see this. I do need to lift that a bit. Wrong way. That's better. Keep forgetting that low Norfolk is flat. Fields aren't. They do undulate quite a bit. And I wish I hadn't tried to say that. Yeah, as I was saying, I've been having multiple problems with Heritage Farms. The potato and the potato lifter I bought, potato and beef lifter I bought, works well until you come to unload it. And I've been trying to get that to unload properly all weekend, and I gave up. Now I found some other things to use, but they're not quite as old. That was only a mid-60s thing. The problem was, you had a gap. You actually fit three trailers between the unload point and the actual piece of equipment. One of the problems you've got here is you can't actually see where you've been, so this is going to be double sprayed quite a bit. If we come in here, I see these things working quite often around here. Don't know about nights, but you certainly see this type of gear. I think we've done most of it already. I'd probably have been better off to use GPS. Marvellous BP study used GPS, and I stopped again. I think we will go back down towards the gate and we will be done. Yeah, that'll do. I just going a bit closer here, and you see all four wheels are steering. Now, as soon as we fold this up, it goes back to two-wheel steer. What's that doing? Once that's folded, we'll just have a quick look around, see if he's doing well. I'm not expecting to get any of this done today. And I'm going to put you through it, and you're going to have to watch the rest of this next week before we start the seed. Oh, it's going to take a long time to get these two done. I do like these power harrows. They're better than the original one I had. And I believe these, if you've got manual attachment, and you've actually gone ahead and put the pipes on, this has the pipe, these have the pipes on to connect in. See what he's doing now. Just watch him drop one in. Should almost. Oh, he's 90%, so he's as good as full. One more load and he'll be off again. Can't remember what I've got him set to. No, he's off now. He's had enough already. Oh, I think we can get rid of the rest of that core showing there. Better. Right, back to. Don't want to do that one, I want to do this one. Here we are. Right, we're going to check the next field out. And this has also got another little trick up its sleeve. Just show that off. I think this should do it. Not so here to the. Here we are, look at the wheels. You can change the track and narrow up. Or wide, so it depends what you grow on, you can actually change your track. And I put that pretty wide for going out on the road. Nice little touches on this. Well, that should keep going. As you see, the moisture's down to 30-odd% in the centre of the field. Even if it does rain, and we get a lot of rain, we're still going to need this. So what we do now, we'll go out of here and we'll check these ones. Oh, we'll do 12 on the way back. I think we've got enough capacity in here to do all the fields. I think I might use GPS on the next one. I'm not certain either what this meadow's like for moisture. Have a look. Oh, that's not too bad. A bit acidic though. Did we put anything on there? A beer patch ready to see. No, I don't. Yeah, we might have to come and line this field. This is another one I want from this. It's the farm, this particular contraption. I'm not going to be renting all the time. It's only to get us going. I'm renting to get things actually moving again. Which one do we come to first? Gateway. This one. Let's have a look. See what this is like. Shouldn't really drive on it, but I'm feeling lazy. That's fine. That is fine. Nothing wrong with that. It is quite damp already. I didn't check too, was this in the farm? Oh well. See what this one's like. This had a bit more growth, so it may well. I thought I'd hit it on something. Yeah, this could do with some. Come over here. Now, I think this is the field we've got to put a grass strip up on this side. There's the ploughs and the ploughing, even using six turns, it still catches the fence. So just pull it a bit. So look. Don't want this up anymore. I'm not going to do a course play. Just trying to level this off a bit. I'm not too worried if I don't get the edges dead on. Think that'll do. Looks about right, so we'll give it a go. And we need just to auto whip 41 meters, right? No offset. Look, going forward, but that looks about right. Oh. Cruise. I think we just slowed down the cruise. I think I was doing about 13 before. Wrong one. Oh yeah, this is very low. Give it 14, see what happens. Otherwise I'm going to do 13, so that's fine. And we're going to miss that top corner. This is slightly acidic too. I'm going to have to lime everything end of this year. Take the opportunity to have a quick slurp. Stop. And we hit the fence. Good job I ended up damaged mod on this one. The line to appear at the edge there, so we must be think we can lift that line up, if I remember right. Auto run, corset. Yeah, that's set up a bit. We can see it a bit better now. Forward we go again. Oh no, I didn't do. I didn't actually put it onto the course. Of course we didn't. We could actually lower this. This is a flatter field than the last one. Be one more pass on this field, and we're hardly used any water at all. There we go. I think what we'll do is we'll go once round. Just to get the end bits done. How's he doing? Oh, another lot of silage sold. Oh, we're going to get this done. We could, I think, just done this for a couple of hours. Well, I think I held you here long enough. We'll finish this field. This boy. Getting rid of that. Just go round the outside now. That should be this one done, and we'll get ready to go into the next field. And we've got too close to that fence. Still too close to that fence. Alright, I can hear all my regular sound. It's him again, it's that man again. He's done it again. Now let's see if we can do it this time. We want to start turning about here. If we're going to miss that, shouldn't actually want to do the top end here, it's just the sides. Because this is made by the same person who does that JCB I always seem to be using. The load all. And also the Marshall trailers that I'm always using. Oh, I just want to go up this side. Oh, we can see here where we missed. Yeah, there is actually, you can actually just make out the bits were missed. As BP has said, I think BP has said before, it'd be nice if we could actually turn off some nozzles on this, or turn off one whole bar, and only use about half the amount of water. That looks like we're done now. Right, switch off, bowled up. We take this on to the next field, we'll just have a quick look around, see how everything's doing. Next one should be the next one up on this lot now. It's a good job I haven't got crop destruction on. Next two on the right, of course, are being ploughed at the moment, or harrowed at the moment. And really this, the there we go. Let's see what this one's like. One's not too bad. Let's drive in there a bit. No, I could do with a drop. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just leave this here in the field, and we'll just have a quick round, see how we're doing, what we've got left in here. We've got rid of quite a bit. I need to we'll finish off by following this round just to check. Before we do, we'll just see how they're doing. Almost halfway. And about the same, both almost halfway. So it looks like next time you will have another lot of doing most of what we're doing today. But we'll just follow this round and see where he goes. And I'm going to take the screenshot of him tipping. Looks like I want to wash this tractor. It looks very mucky indeed. But you see, this trailer is Sapatoris again. This one, he took all the dimensions off Marshall's website. So it's correct as close as damn it is to swearing. It's a very nice trailer indeed. It's colourable, not the body. The body stays red, but the flash is where the yellow on this. You have a choice of colours. And I like using them. I use these on Old Ridge, because I can have a different flash colour for whatever crop it's meant to be carrying. And these took over from the Bullet Bill Marshals I was using. Basically, these hold a smidgen more, and they actually look better in my humble opinion. I still like these Marshall trailers. So mods now, it looks like the JCB might be one of those modded ones, the 4 series Marshall JCB. And I think for my heavy tractors, or heavy tractor, I'm going to put either Stevie's case on with the big balloon tyres. All that vent, I like that vent, but I hardly used it. But I also like the Stevie colour on his. His special colour, and it looks nice. It works well. Not a lot more to say. And this is where we tip. So we'll just get ready to take that lot off. I'm guessing that we will be getting slurry from here. Let's just see. Yeah, this should do it. Let's just have a look, see what we are getting out of here. These are greenhouses. I'm not certain of the one. No, these aren't the ones we are. These are just look nice. I think, ah, oh, might be, ah, we might sell slurry here, of course. Yeah, I think this, yeah, could we sell grass, slurry, silage, and muck all up here. These are our greenhouses, and these are ones we actually own, which I will get running at some point. Don't even know how to put any water in them. This is going. I'm now going to use that little cot universal. Anyway, with that, let's hitch a lift. With that, I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. If you like what you saw, please leave a like. If you're not a subscriber and wish to be informed whenever I put a new video up, which is most days, please subscribe. I'm always happy to see new subscribers. I don't bite. Well, I ain't got enough teeth left to bite now. And also, if you've got any comments, questions, and on this map, unlike say Eldridge, if you've got any mods you'd like to see on here, drop me a line with at least a rough idea where I can find it. I will have a look at it. I can't promise, because if it throws up errors, it doesn't go in. I've got too many mods on this map to risk an error-strewn mod. Oh, with one other thing, it must be European appearance. I don't want any of the big American stuff really on this one. That will go on Stevie's Paradise Hills map. But if you've got any of those, let me know and I'll see if I can drop onto the Paradise Hills, which is goes live the day after Blickling. Because this is getting dressed, playing with mods. Which I'm not playing with too many at the moment, but I think we get this out of the way and we can certainly think about showing some more mods in. I think we've by the time we sold this bunker load, we've got a little in the other one which will go into the mix feed. And although I really want to get animals first, not necessarily a lot of animals, but just a few of each. Anyway, with that, it's Merman saying cheerio for now. Cheerio.